Does Donald Trump have a personality disorder? This question seems to have exercised plenty of people recently, including some U.S. voters, his fellow politicians, other world leaders, worried citizens of the rest of the world, and a number of prominent psychiatrists. It is an interesting question, isn't it? The reason for that is that most of us are interested in people, we get intrigued by the inner lives of others, we're interested in personality. But what exactly is personality? Most people would probably say something like that someone's personality is how someone usually is. So that is how they think, respond emotionally, behave, and what their relationships are like, and this is a useful way to think about the subject. How one thinks, feels, behaves and is in relationships is really just how one lives. So when aspects of someone's personality constantly lead to problems in their lives for the individual or those around them, a psychiatrist would say that this may indicate a personality disorder, PD. Can you give an example of someone with a personality disorder, anyone I know? There are several different categories that we use to describe personality disorders. While you may not know the specific diagnoses, you certainly will have come across some of the ways that someone with a personality disorder behaves, hopefully more in the movies or in books than in your personal life. For example, Girl, Interrupted or Betty Blue, both of which portray examples of borderline personality disorder, or We Need to Talk About Kevin, which is about someone with an example of an antisocial personality disorder. However, given that 1-3% of people in the community actually do have a diagnosable personality disorder, you may well know someone with one of these sorts of conditions in your personal life. Why is the Trump presidency of extreme psychological interest? Since the campaign that led to his 2016 election, Donald J. Trump has defiantly flipped the presidential script, making chaos and deliberate combativeness the new normal of White House operations, manifest in hostile briefings, high rates of staff turnover, and cultural exchanges that appear aimed at dividing the nation. There is widespread debate about the degree to which Trump should be held directly or indirectly accountable for changes in civil discourse, with some citing his rhetoric and policies as a spur to hate crimes, while others claim he has been unfairly demonized by the press. Millions of people around the country and the globe have expressed bafflement at the nature of the personality at the center of it all, and many are alarmed by tactics and policies that appear not only erratic but often retrogressive and undermining of long-established democratic practices. Chief among them is a well-documented distortion of facts, if not outright lies, about everything from crowd size at the inauguration to discussions with foreign heads of state. A large segment of the population seeks to quell their emotional reactivity to the chaos of the presidency and to rationally navigate the civic, legal, and ideological battles that play out daily, from Twitter to the federal courts. The president's personality rumps manifest grandiosity and disregard for facts, beginning with failure to accept clear evidence about the size of the crowd attending his inauguration, has put mental health professionals in the spotlight from day one of his presidency. Psychologists and commentators from all ideological camps early converged on a label of narcissistic personality disorder as the condition that explains Trump's behavior. Among those making this assertion are more than 70,000 mental health professionals who signed a petition warning of Trump's potential dangerousness, despite long-standing professional injunctions against diagnosing public figures whom experts have not personally examined. Americans remain divided as to how authoritarian or grandiose Trump may or may not be, as well as who has the authority to make clinical pronouncements or draw historical parallels. At some as yet untested point, the clinical becomes the constitutional. The behavior of President Trump has sparked both legislative action and public discussion about whether and when to invoke the 25th Amendment to the Constitution, which calls for the orderly transfer of power when a president becomes temporarily or permanently incapacitated. Criteria for considering the specific diagnosis of narcissistic personality disorder: a pervasive pattern of grandiosity in fantasy or behavior, need for admiration, and lack of empathy, beginning by early adulthood and present in a variety of contexts, as indicated by five or more of the following: 1. Has a grandiose sense of self-importance, e.g., exaggerates achievements and talents, expects to be recognized as superior without commensurate achievements. 2. Is preoccupied with fantasies of unlimited success, power, brilliance, beauty, or ideal love. 3, believes that he or she is special and unique and can only be understood by, or should associate with, other special or high-status people or institutions. 4. Requires excessive admiration. 5. Has a sense of entitlement, i.e., unreasonable expectations of especially favorable treatment or automatic compliance with his or her expectations. 6. Is interpersonally exploitative, i.e., takes advantage of others to achieve his or her own ends. 7. Lacks empathy, is unwilling to recognize or identify with the feelings and needs of others. 8. Is often envious of others or believes that others are envious of him or her. 9. Shows arrogant, haughty behaviors or attitudes.